kind of grown up and lived, you know, in the sort of Vancouver region a certain way. And I moved to California, and I know that amongst my coworkers and just almost, you know, anybody we interacted with, I just kind of saw a lot of diversity in San Francisco. Like sort of, you know, pedestrian level, like it was just a really, really diverse space. And I remember moving back here and, you know, after about 2 years, I just kind of took a look around and I was just kind of shocked a couple times, actually. There's a couple of incidents. And there's a couple times I was just kind of shocked at, you know, just the apprehension that I kind of saw between some communities, and in cases where there wasn't any apprehension, just lack of understanding or maybe even just lack of curiosity. And it kind of made me, you know, think about what, you know, culture or multiculturalism means in Canada. And I kind of started then thinking about this whole notion that, you know, we pride ourselves in being a multicultural society, but it's kind of like a bento box of cultures. You know, everybody is nicely packaged and neatly separated. On the one hand, you have, I think, just the sort of position of safety that comes out of, you know, kind of new immigrants perhaps, you know, clinging a little bit to culture, maybe even clinging a little bit to like-minded community members. And then beyond that, we even had, you know, sort of our government's policy of looking at multiculturalism as a very segmented sort of thing of, you know, you are from a certain community, you are from a certain culture, and if you're a visible minority, you know, which visible minority are you? And that system of tagging even, I think, is, you know, it's pretty dated, and there's a lot of flaws in it. I think the legacy of it is probably just, you know, it's a safety and security thing. You know, there's obviously, you know, loads of issues and problems with the American system. I'm not, you know, promoting that by any means. But I do think there's something to be said for that melting pot sort of philosophy that says, you know, you're going to contribute what's unique about yourself to the whole, right? And it kind of creates this approach where your cultural background, it informs your identity. Right? It doesn't necessarily define it. I think in Canada especially, we treat racism as a bit of a dirty word almost, right? We're afraid to say it. But race relations, I mean, it's a mountain with no top, right? It's something that you have to continuously keep climbing. You know, when everybody's compartmentalized and worried about very internal issues in small sort of microcosms, they don't see themselves as a part of a whole. They don't see themselves as a part of a greater system, right? So when you look at the problems that are facing the world today, you know, from global warming to, you know, you name it, you know, financial crisis, et cetera, et cetera. When you don't have all of these sort of individual parts, you know, realizing that they're part of the whole, you can't actually rely on and you can't actually harness the full creative and productive power of a community to solve any of these problems.